Today, you're going to learn about the different birth control methods that are available to you to help you prevent an unwanted pregnancy. After seeing this video, we hope you better understand how birth control works. Birth control methods can help you plan, prepare for, and space pregnancies. They can greatly reduce the chances of having an unplanned pregnancy. The good news is that never before have so many effective and safe birth control methods existed. The best solution is to make birth control part of your everyday routine. Before we talk about specific birth control methods, let's review how pregnancy happens and the basics of human anatomy. This may help you to better see how each type of birth control method works. During sexual intercourse between a man and a woman, the penis enlarges, becomes hard, which is called an erection, and is inserted into the vagina. During the muscular contraction of the male climax, which is called ejaculation, millions of sperm are released into the vagina. If the sperm and egg meet in the woman's fallopian tube, the egg is fertilized. The fertilized egg moves through the tube into the uterus, where it attaches to the wall and grows into a baby. This is a picture of a man's reproductive system. Unlike a woman's, most of the male's reproductive system is visible from the outside of the body. The main reproductive organ of the male is the testes. The testes, found inside the scrotal sac, make the male hormone testosterone as well as sperm. When a man gets sexually aroused, sperm leave the testicles, move into the tubing called vas deferens, and enters into the urethra, where it will pass out of the tip of the penis. As it makes its way out of the body, it passes several glands that add a cloudy fluid called semen. When a man ejaculates, his semen may contain as many as 900 million sperm. Those millions of sperm can live within the female body for up to 5 days. If a woman has sexual intercourse twice a week without using birth control, she has living sperm inside her body for the entire month. This is a picture of the woman's reproductive system. It contains many parts, but the main female reproductive organ is the ovary. Ovaries produce the two female hormones, estrogen and progesterone, that are responsible for a woman's menstrual cycle. Ovaries also store hundreds of thousands of eggs. When a girl starts her period, this means that her ovaries are mature and able to release an egg each month, usually around day 12 to 17 of her cycle, although ovulation, or the release of an egg, can occur any time during her cycle. When the egg is released, it moves from the woman's ovaries into her fallopian tube. While in the fallopian tube, the egg will join the sperm. You will learn about contraceptive methods that may prevent fertilization. From the fallopian tube, the fertilized egg moves down into the uterus and attaches to the lining of the uterus. When this happens, a pregnancy will occur. If the sperm does not join with the egg, a period will occur. This cycle will repeat itself over 500 times in the average woman's lifetime. It is important for women to know that having a period means that everything is okay. If couples have sexual intercourse without birth control, the result is often an unplanned pregnancy. It's now time to learn about the various methods of birth control. You will see how each method works, their advantages and disadvantages, and their possible side effects. Birth control methods work in many ways. Some prevent fertilization from occurring. Others prevent the egg's release from the ovary or prevent the egg from reaching the sperm. Some birth control methods prevent sperm from getting in the vagina, while others kill sperm or keep sperm from reaching the uterus. Certain methods may change the lining of the uterus so that the egg cannot attach. All birth control methods can be broken down into two groups, those using hormones and those not using hormones. Birth control methods that use no hormones are abstinence, natural family planning, or NFP, condoms, spermicides, and diaphragms. Birth control methods that use hormones include the combined pills, progestin-only pills, patches, vaginal rings, and shots. Paragard IUDs do not contain hormones, while Mirena IUDs do. All methods work in a special way to prevent pregnancy. We will first talk about birth control methods that use no hormones. The Paragard IUD will be discussed later. The first and most effective method of non-hormonal birth control is abstinence. For pregnancy prevention, abstinence means not having any sexual activity that puts sperm near the vagina. This is the only 100% effective birth control method. With abstinence, there are no side effects, but it may be difficult to stick to the decision to say no. The benefits of abstinence are many. Abstinence is free. It's completely effective. It can be used at any time. And it is the only 100% way to protect against sexually transmitted infections, or STIs, including HIV/AIDS. Remember, you have the right to choose not to have sex. Even if you have already had sex, you may decide not to continue to be sexually active. You may not be emotionally prepared to have sex, or you may have concerns about getting sexually transmitted infections. If you want to learn some ways that will help you say no to having sex, ask your healthcare provider. The next birth control method without hormones is natural family planning, or NFP. Natural family planning, or periodic abstinence, is a method where couples do not have sex on fertile days. Fertile days are the days of the month when a woman is most likely to become pregnant. Those days are just before, during, and after an egg is released from the ovary, which is called ovulation. To use this method, a woman records her temperature, type of vaginal fluid, and dates of her period on a calendar. This record predicts when she is most likely to get pregnant. One advantage of natural family planning is that it teaches women about their fertility pattern. Another advantage is that both partners play a part in preventing pregnancy. If this method is used correctly every time, there's a 95 to 98% chance of preventing a pregnancy. A major disadvantage of natural family planning is that it is difficult to use if your period is irregular. Also, it takes time to learn this method, and there will be days when you must not have sexual intercourse. Natural family planning does not protect you from sexually transmitted infections or the virus that causes HIV/AIDS. Your healthcare provider will tell you how to use this method if you are interested. The single-use condom, another method without hormones, acts as a barrier by preventing sperm from reaching the egg. Today, both male and female condoms exist. When used correctly with a spermicide every time, male condoms are 98% effective and female condoms are 95% effective in protecting a woman from getting pregnant. Male condoms are inexpensive and come in many colors, styles, and sizes. They fit snugly over the erect penis. The female condom is placed into the vagina and can be inserted for up to 8 hours before sex. There are some disadvantages of using condoms, however. They may prevent spur-of-the-moment sex. They're needed for every act of intercourse. Partners must agree to use them. They may cause decreased feeling, or they could tear, slip off, or may cause an allergic reaction to the latex. Use latex-free condoms if an allergy exists. They work just as well to prevent both pregnancy and sexually transmitted infections. Both types of condoms can be easily bought without a prescription from a drugstore or obtained from the health department. Spermicides are inexpensive and popular over-the-counter birth control methods without hormones. These include foams, jellies, creams, vaginal suppositories, and films. Spermicides are inserted high into the vagina before sexual intercourse in order to kill sperm before they enter the uterus. Unfortunately, many couples don't always follow directions, which lowers the spermicide's effectiveness. Also, spermicides may be inconvenient or messy, and they must be used each time a couple has sexual intercourse. The most common side effect is a possible allergic reaction or irritation in either the woman or her partner from the ingredients in the spermicide. If this method is used correctly every time, there's a 94% chance of avoiding a pregnancy. There are no serious risks. The last method without hormones is the diaphragm. The diaphragm is a shallow, bendable rubber cup that fits high inside the vagina to cover the cervix and block sperm from entering the womb. This is what the diaphragm looks like. It must be used with a sperm-killing jelly or cream. Diaphragms come in several sizes, and you will need your healthcare provider to measure you for a correct size and fit. The healthcare provider will show you how to insert the diaphragm and check for correct placement. An advantage is that it can be put into the vagina up to 6 hours before intercourse, allowing for spontaneity. However, the diaphragm should not be removed until 6 hours after intercourse to make sure all the sperm has been killed. Another advantage is that there are no side effects unless you are allergic to latex or spermicides. There are some disadvantages to the diaphragm. Some women develop bladder or yeast infections. Some women don't like putting objects into their vagina, or they find it's hard to insert or messy. The diaphragm can get holes in it, and if it's left in the vagina for over 24 hours, some women may develop pelvic or urinary tract infections. Also, the spermicide used with the diaphragm does not provide protection from sexually transmitted infections or HIV/AIDS, so always use a condom along with the diaphragm and spermicide. To be as effective as possible, the diaphragm should be checked after each pregnancy or after a 10-pound weight gain or loss. If used correctly every time, there's about a 94% chance that a woman will not get pregnant when using a diaphragm. We will now discuss birth control that contains hormones. These include pills, patches, rings, and shots. Marina IUDs contain hormones, but will be discussed later. Birth control methods that contain hormones all basically prevent pregnancy the same way. They thicken cervical mucus, making it difficult for sperm to enter the womb, and they cause the lining of the womb to become thin so the egg cannot attach. Some disadvantages include spotting, breast tenderness, headaches, and nausea. These side effects usually go away after the first few months of starting the method. Today, most women don't even experience these side effects because the amount of hormone used in today's birth control is so low. If, however, unpleasant side effects don't go away, a different brand of pill or another method can be tried. It does not mean that a woman cannot use hormonal birth control. Remember, finding the right birth control is like finding the right blue jeans. The right fit is essential. In order to test the fit, you have to try them on. If one method doesn't work, just try another one until you find the right fit. The risk of death or other problems during pregnancy and childbirth are much greater than the risk of taking hormonal birth control. All hormonal methods are convenient. Birth control that contains hormones makes periods lighter and less painful. All improve low iron or anemia caused by monthly blood loss and decrease the chance of painful ovarian cysts. All methods protect against cancers of the ovaries, uterus, and its lining. In addition, all decrease non-cancerous breast lumps and improve acne, a benefit especially important to teens. Lastly, all hormonal birth control gives some protection against pelvic inflammatory disease. Unfortunately, no hormonal birth control method protects against sexually transmitted infections, including HIV/AIDS, so always use a condom regardless of the method you choose. The main differences between the pill, patch, vaginal ring, and shot are how the method is used, the different amounts of estrogen and types of progestins that are used, and the length of time the method keeps the egg in the ovary to prevent pregnancy. The pill keeps the egg in the ovary for 1 day. The patch keeps the egg in the ovary for 1 week. The vaginal ring keeps the egg in the ovary for 1 month. And the shot keeps the egg in the ovary for 3 months. Some methods are easier to remember to use or take than the others. All birth control methods must be used correctly and consistently in order to prevent pregnancy. The combined pill is the most widely used birth control method by women and teens in the United States. It uses two hormones, estrogen and progestin, to prevent pregnancy. The combined pill is extremely effective, safe, and is reversible. If this method is used correctly every time, there is a 99.7% chance of preventing a pregnancy. However, it has one of the highest failure rates because women forget to take the pill each and every day. Since the hormones in birth control pills only keep the egg in the ovary for 1 day, if you forget to take a pill every day, the hormone level in your body starts to drop. When your hormone level drops, there is always a chance that an egg may be released from the ovary. This explains why many women get pregnant while taking birth control pills. Pills need to be taken every day to prevent pregnancy, so if you decide to use the pill as your birth control method, think of fun ways to remind yourself to take the pill each day at the same time until you have developed a good pill-taking habit. The risks of taking combined pills include the chance of blood clots in the legs or lungs, stroke, high blood pressure, and heart attack. Most serious complications occur in women over 35 years of age who smoke. The combined pill may also increase the risk of liver tumors and gallbladder disease. Mini pills are another type of birth control pill that contain only one hormone called progestin to prevent pregnancy. The mini pill works in the same way as the combined pill, but because it only uses progestin and not estrogen, it can safely be taken by nursing mothers, women with high blood pressure, women who smoke, or women who cannot tolerate estrogen. Mini pills may cause spotting, irregular bleeding, or missed periods. However, unlike combined pills, you must use a backup method, such as condoms, film, or foam, if you are 3 hours or more late taking the mini pill. So, it is very important that you take the mini pill at the same time every day. Here is a picture of the birth control patch. It contains hormones, and on one side is coated with an adhesive so it will stick to skin. The birth control patch delivers a steady amount of estrogen and progestin through the skin to prevent pregnancy. Each patch delivers enough hormones to keep the egg in the ovary for 1 week. Because the patch provides weekly and not daily protection, some women find it easier and more convenient to use than pills. However, a new patch must be applied every week for 3 weeks in a row. The fourth week is patch-free, and a period should occur. Patches can be worn on only 4 places: the lower abdomen, the upper arm, the back, or buttocks. Some problems with patches are that they may become partially or completely detached. Also, the skin under the patch may become irritated and cause itching. The patch may also be slightly less effective for women weighing more than 198 pounds. The patch is 99% effective if used correctly and is ideal for women who may forget to take pills. The vaginal ring is made of polyurethane and contains 2 hormones to prevent pregnancy, just like the pill and patch. The ring is 99% effective in preventing pregnancy if used correctly. The ring is inserted into the vagina and used for 3 weeks in a row. During the 4th week, the ring is removed and a period starts. There is no wrong way to insert the ring, making it very easy to use. You simply insert it into the vagina and push it up as high as possible. If you can't feel the ring, it's in the correct place. Women can swim, exercise, bathe, and have sexual intercourse without it falling out or worrying about it not working. The vaginal ring does not absorb odors, semen, or secretions. It does release hormones at a steady rate for 3 weeks across the lining of your vagina. A disadvantage may be a person's fear of putting objects inside the vagina. The vaginal ring must be stored at temperatures less than 85 degrees Fahrenheit. If you're interested in this method, your healthcare provider will show you a ring and tell you when to start using your ring. Birth control shots are given in the arm or buttock. The shot usually contains one hormone, progestin, which keeps the egg in the ovary for 3 months and thins out the lining of the womb. By preventing pregnancy for 3 months, the shot gives women convenient and long-acting pregnancy prevention. Side effects of the shot include menstrual changes. Most women notice a change in how often they have their periods. Some women may spot or experience heavy bleeding in the beginning. However, the longer the shot is taken, the less likely irregular bleeding will occur. In fact, a majority of women's periods will stop altogether. But this is not dangerous. Periods stop because the lining of the womb becomes very thin. Remember, there is no medical benefit of the period. Some women have other side effects, such as weight gain or bone thinning. Using the shot for more than 2 years may cause bone thinning, which may not be completely reversible once the shot is stopped. If women choose shots as their birth control method, they should take calcium supplements to help their bones stay strong. The birth control shot is very safe and reversible, but women are advised to stop the shots 1 year before they want to become pregnant because it can take that long to return to full fertility. The implant is another method of birth control that contains one hormone called progestin. It is a flexible plastic single rod the size of a matchstick, and it's placed under the skin of your inner arm. You will be able to feel the rod through your skin. Your healthcare provider can remove the implant at any time you want. If you don't want to get pregnant, you should start another birth control method right away. If you decide you want to become pregnant after using the implant, you may be able to do so quickly. The implant's most common side effect is menstrual changes. These may include irregular periods, spotting, or heavier or lighter bleeding. Some women may have other side effects, such as weight gain, mood swings, headaches, or acne. The implant prevents pregnancy for 3 years, therefore it gives women long-lasting pregnancy prevention. In addition, the implant is 99% effective in preventing a pregnancy. Now we're going to talk about intrauterine birth control devices, which are called IUDs. An IUD is a small piece of bendable plastic or metal that contains copper or a hormone. Your healthcare provider inserts the IUD into the uterus through the vagina in a very simple and safe office procedure. IUDs are considered to be the most effective form of birth control. Today's IUDs are very safe. The Paragard IUD prevents pregnancy for 10 to 12 years using no hormones. The copper wire surrounding the plastic frame acts as a spermicide to kill sperm. The Mirena IUD uses the hormone progestin to keep the egg in the ovary for 5 years. It also thins out the lining of the womb, so an egg cannot attach to the uterus. Women who have more than one sex partner or have multiple partners should not use IUDs because of possible infections. Some women experience a small amount of cramping or pain when the IUD is inserted. Women who use the Paragard IUD may have more painful cramps and heavier bleeding during their periods. Sometimes the IUD can be suddenly expelled. To make sure the IUD is in place, check the string once a month after your period, or if you have unusual cramps or bleeding. The string should be felt in the vagina. Never pull on the string. If you have any questions or concerns about the string, call your healthcare provider. The last birth control method we will discuss is sterilization. Sterilization should be considered a permanent method of birth control because this surgical procedure is usually not reversible. Female sterilization is the most commonly used birth control method in the world. This means if you're a woman, you must expect that after sterilization, you will never be able to get pregnant. If you're a man, you should expect that after sterilization, you will probably never be able to father a child. You should not be sterilized unless you are sure that you don't want any more children. To consent to sterilization, you must be at least 21 years old, understand what sterilization means, and you must be competent to make decisions for yourself. Sterilization for men is called a vasectomy. This surgery is done in the healthcare provider's office. The healthcare provider cuts and seals the tubes that carry the man's sperm. Sterilization for women is called a tubal ligation. This surgery may also be done as an outpatient procedure. The fallopian tubes that carry the woman's eggs are cut and sealed. There are no major long-term effects from sterilization. Like all birth control methods except condoms, sterilization offers no protection against sexually transmitted infections or HIV/AIDS, so always use a condom. There may be a small chance of problems after surgery, such as bleeding or infection. Sterilization is 99.9% effective in preventing pregnancy. Emergency contraception is a method to prevent pregnancy after unprotected sex when a contraceptive method fails or when a woman has experienced sexual assault. Emergency contraception can be taken up to 120 hours or 5 days after unprotected sexual intercourse. The sooner it is taken, the more likely it is to be effective. Emergency contraception is around 89% effective at preventing a pregnancy, depending on how promptly a woman uses it, when during her cycle she had sexual intercourse, and the kind of emergency contraception she takes. Emergency contraception does not cause an abortion, and it does not affect an established pregnancy. Emergency contraception uses hormones to keep the egg in the ovary until all the sperm dies. It does not replace regular birth control use, nor does it prevent sexually transmitted infections, including HIV/AIDS. Emergency contraception is completely safe for all women, regardless of age or medical condition. All sexually active women who do not wish to be pregnant should obtain a yearly prescription or supply of emergency contraception from their healthcare providers. If you're in need of emergency contraception, talk to your healthcare provider. It's available over the counter if you're 18 years old or over. If you're under 18 years of age, you may get emergency contraception with a prescription. I hope you've learned something about your body as well as the different birth control methods that are available to you to prevent pregnancy. It is up to you and your healthcare provider to find the right one. Many women get easily frustrated and stop their method without ever talking with their healthcare provider and may end up experiencing an unintended pregnancy. If you have trouble with your method, call your healthcare provider. If you're a teen, we encourage you to discuss this important decision to become sexually active and to use birth control with your parents or other adult in your life. Remember, if you are sexually active, birth control is the only way for a woman to plan, prepare, and space her pregnancies. Every pregnancy should be your decision. Thank you for your time and attention.